Remember going over the things for the contract? If a employee gets hurt on the job, the township will pay his insurance for 1 year. If he gets hurt off the job, we'll pay it for 18 months.
Well, I think sickness and accident kicks in under that agreement, which is why the times are different.
Ready for office?
Sure.
Dear Board of Supervisors, dated July 12th, 2017, I've worked around the township for the past 24 years as the elected real estate tax collector, 8 years as earned income tax collector, past 6 years as secretary and treasurer. I would like to thank the Board of Supervisors for being so great to work with. I'd like to thank Doug Teagarden for all the administrative help he's given me over the years. I'd first like to thank Dave, Doug, and Zach for hiring the CPA, clearing my name and reputation after the accusations were made of my misappropriating money. A statement made that money was missing, which was have been proven to be false. I never claimed to have all the answers or know everything. I do know that I am given more than 100% to do my best to serve as Dunham Township Secretary Treasurer. Since with a heavy heart, I decided to resign from my position Secretary Treasurer effective August 3, 2017. Motion later in the agenda.
Is all you have for your office?
I'll have other motions in the agenda.
Public comment on items on the agenda.
It might be appropriate, though, to jump ahead and make a motion to add items to the agenda. So that
we do have, when it goes down to the section.
I know, but we've opened it up for public comment on agenda items.
Okay.
So you need to put those on the agenda.
Okay. Can't we let them ask the questions if we put them on the agenda?
Well, again, well, you're now doing a hybrid of public comment.
Well, we simply let them comment if they want to.
That is what we said.
Kathy?
I just need clarification back here. Where the following road bonding escrow money needs to be released. I understand all of it except where it says Donegal Township General Fund, $1,000 from Black's Logging to cover repairs on Buck Run Train. This company was never issued a permit because application was never completed. Are you refunding your money?
No.
It's going back to the general fund. From his escrow, the $1,000's going to the general fund.
Oh, okay.
Because
so he did
they
actually
didn't
give you the money then.
Which they paid $1,000. They never completed their application or anything. So.
Did it, Kathy?
That's it for me.
Anybody else? Darren?
Doug, I just had a question. If you were talking about the building that you're going to build out the township, is that going to go out for bid this month?
Do you think
you'll have that together to go out this month?
He says it will. He'll have it ready out and ready for approval beginning of next month, beginning of August.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, one meeting will probably open the bid, and then there'll be another session to actually award them. They'll want to review the bid.
Any other questions? Go ahead, JD.
I would like to go on the record that I request to reserve the right to address items on the agenda as they are brought up and discussed, like we have in the past.
You can make that request. We're not granting it. I'm not granting it.
That's fine. I just want to go on the record that I requested to reserve my right to address the agenda items as discussed.
Anybody else? Good Bob.
You talked earlier about Range Resources and what they've done on the roads. Grimes Road, they went through and put their guardrail up. They put in a nice roadway. They put in berms, but they never shot the berms. So now all the berm materials washed out onto the roadway. If anybody gets out there on a motorcycle, it's quite dangerous. I don't understand why they allowed not to shoot that berm and just leave it in the condition that they left it in and have it wet out.
You want to go out and look at it, Ed?
I've seen it.
Have you seen it? You going to get a hold of Alexis or?
I can get a hold of somebody tomorrow and see what they can do about it.
All right.
We got an issue at the bottom down there. They patched that three or four times now.
It's coming apart again right now. Any other questions? Approval of the minutes following were submitted for approval June 14, 2017. Motion to approve the minutes of June 14, 2017.
Well, so moved.
Second.
Mr. Ely?
Yes.
I vote yes. Mr. Prescott?
Yes.
Announcements. The Board of Supervisors held an executive session on July 6, 2017 at 6 p.m. with the Operating Engineer Union Representative for the purpose of negotiating the road department's contract. Additional additions to the agenda.
Okay. Ed, you won the permission to purchase pipe?
Yeah.
Okay, can you give me the facts of that, please?
$15 pipe, $6.80 for a foot. I like to order half a truckload of 40 pieces. That's how I get my better price.
And what's your better price?
$5,440. $6.80 is the better price.
Okay. $5,440 from whom?
Northern Panhandle Pipe Supply.
I will move that we purchase that pipe.
Second. Any questions? Good, Darren.
That stuff like that, you don't have to put out for bid then. It makes it easier.
Well, it's a dollar threshold and it doesn't meet that threshold.
Any other questions?
Mr. Ely?
Yes.
I vote yes. Mr. Prescott?
Yes.
Okay, Ed, what other purchases did you request? International trucks.
The international trucks from U.S. Municipal.
This, you have to talk slow, but I'm trying to read so I can read.
Fine bastard.
Okay. International truck.
Okay. Steel body, Go Stars, U.S. Municipal.
Tennis steel body. Okay. Whole thing's CoStar, correct?
Yes.
And you want to explain what CoStar is for those people who might not know?
Tammy can explain it better than I can. It's something through the state. The state puts out a bid packet. They take the bids and only certain people get them for certain products. So if it's a CoStar, then it doesn't have to go out for bid, because the state's already bid.
Okay, so if we do.
It already has cost breakers on each other.
Right, correct. And we've actually got various prices of what he's got. We even get this in advance. Okay, so you talk about international truck with stainless steel body, the CoStar, and U.S. Municipal is selling us what? Truck or the body or?
The truck will come from, I think, Livestar International. The body companies don't deal in trucks.
Right.
So that's going to come from a fleet somewhere, you know, somebody that sells Internationals or Peterbilt. And they'll just do the body, the hydraulics, and the truck will come in to them and they'll assemble it and bring it to us.
Okay. And that price is $118,739?
That's correct.
And if you order it now, there is a small chance that we might get it before it snows.
Very small chance.
Okay, I thought so. I'll move that we grant that CoStar purchase.
Second.
Some of these out of Act 13 funds.
Is that your motion?
Yes.
Second.
Any questions? Go ahead, JD.
I guess the only question I would have there is what the difference on the stainless steel body is compared to, you know, just the standard body, because I would think it would be considerably more, which if the whole thing was stainless and they'd keep everything else from rusting, that would be great. I understand the purpose of the stainless body, but you still got the frame and the rest of the truck that's going to rust away and the bed's going to last unless you intend on taking the bed off and putting it on the next truck.
Now you're thinking like I am.
So, I'm just, you know what I mean? But also, time-wise, in getting the truck, it's probably going to take you longer to get the truck with the stainless body than the standard.
The body part's not the problem. It's getting the truck to the body shop and then it goes into line to be assembled. What he explained to me, and this was several months ago when we started talking about trucks, probably late last winter when I started talking to him, he said, if we got in now, we'd have a 3-month wait. But he said, with all the Act 13 money and everything coming in, he said, they won't bump you ahead no matter what kind of customer you are. When you put your order in, your number goes in. When your truck arrives, it gets a sticker put on it, and it goes through the shop.
What is the difference between the stainless body versus just a steel?
They don't eat out.
They what?
They don't eat out.
No, I mean money-wise.
I didn't price the regular one because I didn't want it.
How long will they last?
Depends. Stainless steel should last you long enough. The one we have up here now, it's 20 years old. It's a 97. It has a steel body, and the bed's about completely shot on it.
But so does the rest of the truck, right?
The wiring's shot on it, and the floorboard's probably getting a little thin. We did squeaker through another inspection.
That was my point. Just, you know, I mean, if you can make the whole truck last, then obviously it's worth it. But if not, you're going to weigh the difference in the price.
I believe the truck was $84,000. The hydraulics and the bed and stuff was $33,897. Well, next time around, you may only have to spend $80,000, not $118,000. You know, you save yourself $33,000. You're still going to have some hydraulic cables and stuff for your setup. If they won't interchange, but if they interchange, then you just go swap the bed and the cylinder, and you got another truck. That's what I'm looking at. And the aluminum gets so brittle, that salt and stuff, it just makes the welds on it brittle for some reason. And then we got to run it over to the Lagonda machine and get it welded, and it's just a headache. And the stainless, we have the one on the floor, and it seems to be holding up quite well.
Any other questions? How you vote?
Mr. Ely?
Yes.
I vote yes. Mr. Prescott?
Yes.
Motion carries. Okay, Ed, you wanted a, we have to have a mower, correct?
Yes.
And you have one that you wanted, you recommended that we purchase. So what was that mower?
The Rhino DB150.
Rhino DB150. That's a 50-inch rotary with a double chain guard.
60-inch rotary.
Okay, 60-inch rotary. DB150 hydraulic ditch bank mower. And the cost is $11,207.
Okay. What I'd like to do on that is to for you guys to make a motion to buy one. Let's see how we like it here, and let's try to get two of them. We got two tractors that we could be mowing with. This mowing kills us in the summertime. You know, with these mowers not running, these old mowers that we had, I was sort of glad that one valley took a shit on us. I'm tired of working on them.
I'll have to put that in the minutes.
But we did, you know, we got two tractors, and these mowers can be taken off. I talked to this guy that has one, He said they're easily come off, they got their own stands. He said, so your tractor's freed up to do something else, which we can drag with them. We can blade, we can wood chip with them, you know, we don't have the tractor tied up with a mower on. And that's one of the reasons why I looked.
Every time.
And he said they are heavy.
I would make a motion to approve one, purchase of one, try it out. Support the way we think it suits us, and we can bump it to settlement.
I'll second.
Any questions?
What's the minimum?
It'd be paid for with that 13 funds.
Ed?
Yes.
What's the smallest tractor, what's the lowest horsepower you can put them on a tractor?
It's in the specs, I think it was 65 or 45, something like that.
Is that like a side boom mower?
It mounts on a three-point hitch arm.
I've seen them.
It runs off the PTO, drives the pump, selfing pump on the mower, got its own hydraulic tank for a counterbalance. And the mower goes out and in and tilts. And that's about it.
Is that a drum disc or a flail mower?
It's a rotary mower, brush haul.
Yeah.
Any other questions?
That's from Evolution Ag LLC, is that correct?
Yes.
Did the 2016 Act 13 payment come in? And how much was that?
$364,000.
60 horsepower minimum.
Guys, I know they were all approved, I just questioned whether you received it yet.
We received it.
Need to vote on.
Mr. Healy?
Yes.
Although yes, Mr. Prescott?
Yes.
Next motion I've got deals with a stop sign. Ed, did you understand everything that Eric, it was a creep to some of us. Did you understand everything Eric had to say about where that sign, could you meet with him and put that sign where it needs to be, so they don't run over?
I do have one question. Do you think we can just put it up, or we have to get PennDOT's approval first?
No, PennDOT won't make an approval because it's not a state road, so that.
It's not a state road?
Right.
So they don't have jurisdiction over it then?
Right, the first chapter there is what gives the municipality the authority to erect those and maintain those.
Is there any way we can move the firehouse back?
There you go.
Nope. It's back as far as it goes, it's a foot from the property line now.
I personally believe, I've looked at it several times, that moving that stop sign back and putting that white bar out next to the highway is a thing to do. You guys keep a bucket of paint there and keep it painted, right?
Whatever it takes.
And it'll lay it out the first time.
Paint the same color as the fire truck, so nothing can miss it.
You saw it have some red paint left over up there.
Actually, I wish I could do that, but the municipal code there that they reference says it has to be white. Yeah, so.
How about white with the safety yellow on the side?
Just white, yeah.
Get a stop sign and flash some lights around.
Move the stop sign west, how's that, on Highland? At an appropriate distance. And install a white bar on the pavement.
Try to get it on that around the first of all, just should have my stop sign guy back by then.
That's your motion?
You're a stop sign guy? He's laughing, he must be. Yeah, that's my motion.
I'll second.
Any questions? JD?
Question, not on that, if I can just, I missed one. On, I guess to Ed, on the pipe. Is there such a thing, like you, all the equipment that you go through Coparts? Or would you go up?
We did with the county on certain things, but
Can you do that with pipe and supplies like that?
Yeah, you can salt, we bid out with the county and stuff on that kind of stuff, but Northern Panhandle has always given me the best price of anybody I've ever called.
Really? Have you, did you check with National Road as well, I assume?
They don't deal in the culvert pipe, they deal in sewer and water, they don't even carry hydraulics in it now, they're more for a water company.
Thank you.
How you vote?
Mr. Ely?
Yes.
I vote yes. Mr. Prescott?
Yes.
Put where you think it needs to be. And you, and by the way, firehouse does look very nice.
Thank you.
Still, we've had a soft opening, we got our trucks in upstairs, but we don't have the bathrooms done, so our grand opening.
You're gonna have a grand opening when you get flush.
We will, yep.
Want to do anything about the escalator?
I don't want it right now.
Okay.
But maybe, I mean, we need to, I think we need to sit down and have a workshop and go over these numbers and see where we're at money-wise and what projects we got pending and we, you know, we've got some money we've got loose from the Dry Ridge Water Line project, was about $275,000 total, and it's going to go to the building project. And then we've got the fire companies, now we've got an S on that, fire companies asking for funds. Did you guys get a mortgage yet?
Yes.
So you guys are safe for a couple of days?
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, we need to sit down and have a workshop session where we can actually continue this meeting to another evening and do a workshop session and make some approvals. That's okay with you guys.
Fine.
I got a motion to accept the resignation of Mark Gordon. I will move to accept the resignation and send him a letter of thanks.
Second. Any questions? How do you vote?
Mr. Ely?
Yes.
Mr. Prescott?
Yes.
And I vote yes, motion carries. I'd like to make a motion to authorize the engineer to draw specifications for the repair or replacement, I should say, replacement of the gym roof. He and I talked about the difference between going with shingles versus going with metal. I think his answer was it's about 20% more expensive to go with metal, but your longevity on it's going to be worth it. We'll never have to worry about that roof ever again unless it blows off the building falls in. I would move that we grant him the authority to draw up justifications and advertise for bids for the replacement of the gym roof. And the bid at shingles and metal. That's my motion.
Second. Any questions? How you vote?
Mr. Ely?
Yes.
I vote yes. Mr. Prescott?
Yes.
Motion carries. The contract with the operating engineers, is it at a stage that we can give tentative approval? And then I will move that we give tentative or give approval to the amended contract with the operating engineers. Expires in 2022. I'll make that as a motion.
Second. Any questions?
And I'm gonna guess when you ship that back to them with the changes in it, they'll execute it and send it back to us, or we have it executed?
I think they're gonna execute it and drop it off to the township.
They're gonna execute it and drop it off to us.
With these changes we discussed.
Well, I'm gonna say, if anybody wants to see it, they can see it when the copy comes by.
Any questions?
How you vote?
Mr. Ely?
Yes.
Everybody, yes. Mr. Prescott?
Yes.
Okay, we have a resignation. I would move that we have an executive session for purposes of personnel. Beginning at 8:35. Any motions?
Questions?
How you vote?
Mr. Ely?
Yes.
Everybody, yes. Mr. Prescott?
Yes.
Executive session, 8:35.
Joe. Rip a mess in the room. I'm telling you, man.